So, hi, here I am again. My name is Wolvinny. Welcome to my YouTube channel. And this is my third episode about dancing in fursuit. And this episode is going to be about how to make a choreography to dance in fursuit, for example, on a dance competition or e-videos or anything you like. Usually around 70, 80, 90% of my dances I've performed so far are choreography. I like to keep a little bit of spaces in between where I can freestyle. For example, if I have to go from one side to another side of the stage, or when it's a little bit of a break in the song, then I can use that moment to catch a little bit of breath. So it's not that you have to decide 100% on choreography or 100% on freestyling. You can also make a combination out of both. Of course, the first thing that you have to do is pick a song. One of the important things for me when you pick a song is that you like it. You shouldn't choose a song just because it's the hype. It really has to get into you and you feel like, yes, this is it. And it's giving you fun. Because if you're having fun, that will show on the stage. Also, it's also okay to mix multiple songs. If you can decide between, for example, two songs, maybe you can try to combine them together. It gives you a chance to show different emotions because you have two songs and maybe they're completely different. One song with a lot of energy, one song with a lot of emotion, and then you can even show more that you have what it takes. But then of course you have to work on how to edit the song and get from one song to another. That's a completely other story. When you have that song picked out, or maybe the two songs picked out, what is the emotion that it's giving you? Is it making you happy, or is it making you sexy, or is it making you funny? You can also, of course, listen to the lyrics of the song. Like, what's the song telling? Is it like a heartbreak song, or is it just a happy song? What I like to do first when I want to dance on the song is first freestyle on the song. Play it in your house, play it in your bedroom, play it in front of a mirror and dance to it and see what it gives you and what you come up with in out of the blue. And if there's something that you really, really liked, I already threw it away, you have to keep a book next to you and write down very quickly like, okay, well, this was a really good thing I came up with. I call it like the happy jump move, and it was around this word in the song, or maybe these seconds in the song. And then you maybe already came up with a choreography bit. Of course, you're not going to get an entire choreography out of freestyling, because freestyling is sometimes very hard to get into words. And then, what are the lyrics telling you? If it's very emotional and it's like the lyrics literally say, I'm crying, I feel sad, I have to do something, then you're maybe going to act instead of do a little bit of dance. You can also act as a dancer. But for example, of course, if they're like singing clap your hands, why not clap your hands, for example? Or freeze! Then you're gonna freeze. Of course, that's more fun. Also, because the audience, if they know the song, they can already think ahead or maybe feel what you were saying, and they're like, oh my god, they're now freezing, that's so cool. So after you've been freestyling and conducting your research in the lyrics and stuff, you should go on YouTube and see what other people did on that dance song. So you can look up the song and then dance behind it, or look up the song and then choreography. Then you can see a lot of inspiration about what other people did, what they came up with, what they were expressing, and it's a lot of big inspiration. And maybe you think like, okay, well, they were sad at that part, I'm gonna try to be sad at part two. Also, of course, you can look into the moves, they really like the moves they did, and try to get some of those. But don't copy an entire dance video from the internet, because that's stealing and you're not going to get a chance to give credit. So please don't copy an entire dance from the internet. You can get some bits. You can grab some bits. It's not like tracing, but it's referencing. And if the dance part is, if you're referencing to, is very difficult, you just grab some of those bits from the dance reference and make it your own. So not copy it one-on-one, but take some elements they were doing and grab something from yourself into it and make it your own. You really have to show your qualities and what you can do in performance and dancing and not copy an entire video from the internet. So, little bits, yes. Referencing, yes. Entire bits, no. The only time I did copy one-on-one from a dance from online is when it was the original dance video from that specific artist. Why? Because you're then referring to the original artist, which is already singing, for example. You're trying to tell their story again, but just do it for maybe 10 seconds or something, maybe 12, 14, 18, and don't do it the entire song. When you're performing in front of a big audience and before the judges, they will get excited for you if they can recognize stuff. They can recognize the song, then you already hear people, if they know the song, they're like, "Ooh, we know the song," you can hear it. But also if they watch the video and they recognize that you are showing bits of the video, they also will show their excitement about it. For example, I did it for Lady Gaga. I've done it for Taylor Swift. Planning. When I make a dance, I like to plan what I'm gonna do. So, for example, when I had to do a dance thingy, I did this. I just doodled down what I think I wanna do around this bit or that bit or this bit or that bit and try to remember it. Okay, so I have a good example here. This is Taylor Swift. I did that on MFF. I divided it in five parts. Five. And I decided in the beginning, I would wake up under a blanket and get up to dance. Then I would dance my first bit. Then around part three, I want to do a little bit of freestyle. Around part four, I wanted to do some tutting. Part five, dance ribbon. Because that is again the what I mentioned before, referencing back to the original song. It's fun to show that you did your research, that you know the song, that you know what the artist, the original singing artist, was expressing, and show it to the audience. If you have a choreography with, for example, the arms, you can also try to doodle them, maybe give them names, or put down a word that's going to be said, and then you're gonna try to learn this. But I like to divide the song in different parts, also for example to set the energy levels of those parts, because a song can be very long. It's 1.5 minutes of giving a lot of your energy in a very tight, warm costume. If you decide that there's gonna be five parts, then for example in the middle part you're gonna have a little bit of a break time or a breather time where you dance slower to catch your breath and catch your energy again and get the audience also a little bit excited, like for getting to the end. If you practice long enough those moves, you're gonna develop something called muscle memory, so that your muscles, whenever they hear the song part, know what they want to do. You can practice the entire song on muscle memory, but that's gonna be a lot of work. And also sometimes it's maybe not smart to only depend on muscle memory, because for example, if you make a little fall or trip and you have to get up again, or if you had a little bit of blackout, then you want to make sure that you can continue again also a little bit on the script that you have in your head. During all of this choreography development, you should just do it in your normal clothes, in your sports outfit, in front of a mirror. And when you are actually trying to dance your rhythm choreography in fursuit, you can also film it to see how it looks. Because maybe the move is too difficult to do in fursuit, then of course it's gonna show on the video as well. But maybe also a move that you saw on the internet was pretty fun to do while normal. Maybe in fursuit it looks a little bit boring. You don't know. Then you can try to see if there is a solution for that. Practice. It's just like learning for an exam. It's okay if you don't get it on the first try after writing it down. Maybe you have to visualize yourself in your head. Maybe you have to visualize words in your head. Maybe you have to give funny names to the moves to remember. Oh yeah, I wanted to do the tornado kick around that part, for example. Give it names, give it an image in your head, and then try to get the script in your head about what are you gonna do in the dance. If you still have a little bit of doubt, it's okay to show your recording to one of your friends or maybe to someone with dancing experience. Show them the video where you are dancing and ask for feedback. It's not a rule that you have to keep everything secret or that you have to do it all on your own. Why not ask people for their opinions and see if they feel like you're telling the story right or that the moves look good. And you're already a really, really big winner if you made it maybe to prelims, but also for trying. Because I've told this before, dancing is a very expressive way of telling a story, but also showing yourself. You're very vulnerable. You're doing something very hard, dancing. And it's even more hard because you're doing it in fursuit. So already, if you're watching this because you want to try to do it one day on those stages, good for you, because it also took me a lot of courage to do it. And after the first try, after I've done it for the first time, I was so proud of myself and I was so happy. And I'm sure you will feel the same when you've done it and it went well. But yeah, if you want to do it well, if you want to be able to watch yourself later on YouTube, you have to do your preparations. So that's why I made these videos for you, so you can maybe try it out one day for yourself. I hope my tips will work. I hope my videos were useful. I have no idea. Just tell me, did you like it? Do you still have questions? Maybe I can answer them in the answers or in the comments below. I'm just really, really happy if you watched this entire thing, and I hope you will get motivation from it or use the tips I've told you. And maybe one day I will see you on a YouTube video, on a dance competition, or maybe on an actual stage. Me in the audience, you dancing there, dancing your butt off and feeling very proud after the dance, like I did when I did my first times, or every time actually. Every time I've been on that stage and I went off and it went well, I was super proud of myself. And that is really victory number one. That's the best prize you can have on that stage. So thank you guys again so very much for watching this YouTube series. I hope you will learn from it. I hope I will see you on stage one day. And I wish you good luck on your first tries on dancing in fursuit. Good luck and thank you so much for watching.